We often hear about Germany's pioneering approach to the energy transition. They call it the Energiewende,
which is a very dramatic word that implies a kind of profound change.
So, what is this Energiewende? Well, essentially, it's a strategy to make Germany climate neutral through a huge economic and societal transformation. In its first Climate Change Act from 2019, the country originally set its net zero commitment for 2050. However, this was moved forward to 2045 by an act of the highest court. The ruling stated that the original act was partly unconstitutional because it shifted the burden of greenhouse gas emissions onto future generations. Pretty progressive stuff. And it has had some pretty impressive results so far. Between 1990 and 2018, greenhouse gas emissions were reduced by 31%. Today, almost half of all electricity in Germany comes from renewable sources, especially wind and solar. And this proportion is rising. This is all the more impressive since the country recently closed all its nuclear power plants and had to partly cover the shortfall with dirty, dirty coal plants. In fact, since 1990, Germany has achieved proportionally the second greatest reduction in greenhouse gas emissions among the G7 group of big countries.
You go, Germany! Yay!
Maybe most importantly, economic growth doesn't seem to be connected to carbon dioxide emissions. In other words, the economy continues to expand while the greenhouse gas emissions are falling. This all goes with a solid public consensus. More than three quarters of Germans would like the energy transition to go further. And well over half the population are prepared to pay more for energy to achieve that goal. This proportion is lower among people who make less money. Among them, 52% are not willing to pay for more cleaner energy. This is perhaps not surprising, given the squeeze on incomes over the last few years. And, oh, you know, all the crushing inequality we're seeing. Hey, let's not forget that the top 10% of earners across the world are responsible for 47% of emissions, while the bottom 50% are responsible for just 10%. It's a scam! So how do we go further? Well, electricity production is well on its way to be decarbonized, but things are lagging behind in industry, heating, and transport. This is because it's just complicated to switch electricity production from big, centralized, smelly coal plants to breezy and beautiful wind and solar plants. But it's actually quite difficult, and in some cases, impossible, to electrify a truck, an aircraft, a high-heat industrial process, or a district heating plant. Well, what's the solution to this problem? Well, there's this little thing called hydrogen. Pure hydrogen is a substance which kilo for kilo contains much more energy than any fossil fuel. The problem is, it's a gas, but not the smelly kind. And a kilo of it takes up a massive amount of space. To fix this, you can either cool it down to almost absolute zero, or squeeze and compress it until it's much smaller. It will still take up a lot of space then, but it can be moved around more easily. It's also highly flammable, like a polyester dress, so you can't leave it lying around, like a polyester dress. These issues can partly be avoided by sticking hydrogen into fuel cells for portable use, keeping it in salt caverns for long-term and large-scale storage, and just generally being clever and inventive. Another option is to convert it to green methanol or green ammonia, which are much more easy to handle. But that kind of conversion uses up a lot of energy, making the whole thing more expensive than your cousin's destination wedding to Hawaii. In conclusion, Germany proves that even a big country can go green without too much fuss. To get there, you need decision makers to implement the right policies, but perhaps more important, you need an informed and engaged population that cares about the planet and each other. Next time on Days of Our Lives. All this big picture climate stuff getting you down? Join us next time when we dive into inspiring stories of people and communities who are taking the lead on climate change action and get empowered along the way. Listen up, my green-hearted glamazons. Infodrag is our runway revolution, twirling science into the spotlight to show off environmental enlightenment with a sparkle. Does it work for you? Drop a comment below with your thoughts, questions, or even just a little bit of love for the series. And darlings, if our eco-extravaganza has lit a fire in your creator's heart, flaunt it, film it, and flash it our way. make sure to tag us in your climate conscious masterpiece. With a little bit of stardust and a little bit of luck, we might just sashay our way into more episodes for you eco-fierce folks out there.